Okay, lovely. Let's get started. Hello and welcome to our first ever episode of Quark Jam. Quark Jam is a live stream where we engage with higher education partners and businesses to increase access to opportunities for youth talent. Today, we will be chatting on the benefits of early stage industrial exposure. So in terms of introduction, my name is Natalie from Quark, and I will be your moderator today. So just giving everyone a bit of context, here at Quark, we advocate youth to get industry exposure through internship and also project-based work, or gigs. We think that getting industrial exposure early on is very important for everyone to become an experienced talent. And today we are going to delve a bit deeper into the future of work and to take a peek into the startups ecosystem and how nowadays startups are starting to bring more youth to their talent pool. Okay, so without further ado, let me just introduce everyone. I'm so happy today because we have an awesome guest speaker coming from Indonesia with us today. Meet Andika Satya from Indigo Hub Bandung, Indonesia. So Bandung is a major city in Indonesia that is very well known as a creative and digital city. It's very well known of its digitalization, if I can say. So Andika is the manager of Indigo Hub Bandung, which is a digital startup hub, and it focuses on incubation activities for rising startups and provides inclusive co-working spaces that are open to the public. He is very experienced in incubator business, startups venture, and app development. Today, I'm also accompanied by my teammates. Today, we have Jacqueline. She is a Piper team from Malaysia. Say hi. Hi, Jack. Jacqueline actively engaged with institutes of higher learning to bridge the gap between next-gen talent and the dynamic manpower needs of businesses and organizations from various industries. She is the expert of matching talent skills to the dynamic work preferences, which are, as we know, are forever changing. Next up, we have Astrid. She is our head of operations in Indonesia. She has been leading our Indonesia expansion, and she works a lot with higher education partners in Indonesia to create engagement activities for students. She is also managing and guiding our awesome interns here at Quark from multiple universities. Okay, enough with the introduction. I will hand it over to my friend Jacqueline to tell us a bit more about Quark, what is industrial exposure, how to get it early on, and why is it so important for us today. Over to you, Jack.
Thank you, Natalie. Good afternoon, everybody. So nice to see all of y'all. Just as an introduction, let me just explain a little bit about what Quark is. Quark is actually a local Malaysian startup. We've been around since 2015, and we are a community of giggers. So we have an application that we use, which helps to match skills and work preferences. And a lot of our next gen talent comes from institutes of higher learning, where I deal a lot with them, and I try to get their students to come on board onto the app and to see what we have to offer. So at Quark, we actually advocate early stage industrial exposure, and this is very important because we have realized that even prior to the pandemic, there was lots of students who actually had very not much exposure at all when it came to working, except when they were maybe doing their internship year, which was a very difficult year for them. It was very stressful because they had to complete final exams and assignments and so on. So they just went into the internship without a correct mindset. They needed to do it because it was a compulsory module to graduate. And we felt that this really didn't give them the opportunity to grow as a person or to gain confidence in themselves and to find out what were their strengths and weaknesses. So when the pandemic happened, actually, we realized that the future of work was changing, trends were changing, and we realized that the students also had to change with it. We cannot predict what is going to happen, but we can predict that things are going to happen and we can try to do it, do something about it right now. Yeah. So at Quark, we try to advocate that students as early as their foundation year or first year when they step into university to look at the opportunity of job exposure, work experience, understanding what the business world is like, And one good way of doing it is to actually work with startups, because a lot of larger or multinational companies, they normally would look for something more long-term or for someone who has got more academic qualification. So I think with the rise of technology right now, as well as a lot of like automation, we have having a lot of disruption going on. So students and institutes of higher learning should change their mindset to see how we can actually leverage on the situation. And so actually, I'm really very happy to have this session with you all this afternoon. Also very interested to hear what Andika has to share about how things are done in Indonesia. So thank you so much, Nat, for that opportunity to share a bit about Quirk and what we advocate.
Thank you, Jack. Now we are a bit clearer about Quirk and what we do here to help youth talent to get opportunities in various industries, especially for students who are interested in knowing a bit more about startup ecosystem. I think it's Kadika turn to share his insights and his experiences and how he get things done at Illico Hub. So over to you, Kadika.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Jack and Natalie. Thank you for having me in this kind of session. This one, for me, is a happy moment. So to share about what is Indigo Hub Bandung and what is what are we doing in Indigo Hub Bandung, especially for the students in the early stage in the startup exposure, for internship, and also for the opportunities that is happening. Okay, let me share. Let me share screen.
Okay. I'm going to flash your screen to everybody. Okay, perfect.
Okay, good. Yeah. Like I'm gonna. Is it okay for me to speak in a bit Indonesian, or is it have to of in a full English?
No. You can mix the language to that. Yeah, it's perfect.
Okay. So yeah. I will be a bit flexible about the. Delivering in Michelle English. So first of all, you can call me Andika. My position in Indigo Hub Bandung is a manager. I've been working or I've been involved in this kind of industry already in 3 years. And I've been creating and starting several startups in Indonesia, some kinds of ups and downs on building a startup. And then I joined with Indigo Hub. Previously, we called this Bandung Digital Valley, one of the well-known incubation and also co-working space in Indonesia, especially in Bandung. And today, I will share you about what is the benefits of early stage industrial exposure, which is what Indigo Hub Bandung is doing, because we are incubating a lot of early stage startups, where we rely a lot with the internship people. So hopefully this will give you some insight about what is happening during internship in early stage in early stage startup. Okay, let me. So first of all, we are kind of have a new branding. We have a brand new brand in 2010. We are running under Indigo Creative Nation, and we have a branding on the co-working space called Bandung Digital Valley. This is maybe for Bandung people or Indonesian. This name is kind of familiar because we are one of the pioneer co-working space and incubation in Indonesia. And in 2021, we are starting to rebranding ourselves. So we in Bandung Digital Valley in line with the Indigo branding. So. Indigo changed the logo, and Indigo Hub Bandung in Bandung Digital Valley transformed to Indigo Hub Bandung. So we have the same branding as Indigo. So this Indigo also have a slogan called "Unlocking Real Access for Every Vision in Indonesia." While Indigo Hub Bandung, we stay with the current responsibilities such. Providing free co-working space, incubation center, and also startup growth partner for all the startup we incubating. as per now, we already have 59 startups that we incubate in Bandung only, and we also have 7,200 plus members that we collect from the visitors and also from the webinars and online events. And then we also have 1,700 plus audiences in 2021 only. Because we have the activity for providing a lot of events like this for public and for free. This is what we are doing in Indigo Hub Bandung. We're providing free co-working space, offline events, startup incubation, corporate visit, and early stage startup coaching. During this pandemic, three of these points is transforming and disrupted by the pandemic. We closed the co-working space, so we obviously we don't have any visitor for today. Offline events we transform and pivoting to online, full online, and then startup incubation also we providing only the employees can only use Bandung Valley but no events whatsoever, and all the incubation process is doing online using Zoom, etc. And we also closed for corporate visits, so we already nearly for 1 year we don't have any meeting with face-to-face with the external entities. And also the latest one is early stage startup coaching that we provide for startup in Bandung City that requires a free mentoring services. This is our startups. We already have 59 startups where the industry came from everywhere, but we have the classification that the startup has to be digital, whether it's agriculture, cybersecurity, financial, education, but it has to be digital. Why is digital startup ecosystem is still hype for today? In 2018, we see that from the MIKTI report in 2019, we have nearly 1,000 startups, but in 2019, 1 year gap, Indonesia has already 2,000 startup. So I think this is the good opportunity because we have 2x growth. I don't know about 2020 or 2021, the report is still non-exist, but I believe the number of startups is still growing by today. Because I can see from the 2020, we only have 6 unicorns in Indonesia, but in the 2021, we already have 8 unicorns with GNT from logistic and also Sendit from the payment gateway. From financial services is already get the unicorns label. So I think this is the good sign that digital startup and digital ecosystem is still potential to be discovered in the future. And then when I look for the digital startup only, when we drill down a bit more about digital economy startup, by the data from Google, Temasek, and Bain Company, you can see this report for public. You can find on the Google as well. But I try to a bit redesign, and I found that the e-commerce and the online media is a survival vertical for these days, especially when the pandemic hit worldwide. Why? Because I think e-commerce provide goods for people that we cannot move everywhere. We are restricted to only in the house. We can only buy anything from home. So e-commerce provide the service that brings the goods to the customer directly. The same goes with the online media. By this working from home trend, we are tend to getting bored easily, right? So online media, including like TechKinesia, TechCrunch, even in Indonesia, the Tech has growth in terms of investment and also the market capitalization is growing during the pandemic. The different things comes with the transport and food. And also online travel. Online travel has the the one that will that with downside and contraction very very low, because we cannot go everywhere. You can go anywhere we want, and we have to stay at home to save ourselves from COVID-19, right? So this is this chart shows us that e-commerce and online media is the has the bright future in maybe 2025. So this is the common position in digital startup. Looking for the startups that in the GoHub Bandung incubates, there are several of position that requires zero proximity requirement. Like you can do this all, you can all do all this in your home without having to meet each other face to face. And the business still working right today for today. From the product research, we have position like UX researcher. They can interview the customer or the target market using Zoom remotely. And UI designer, they can only interact with the computer to design something. And UX writer, technical writer, everything can be done using laptop only. And then the product development, obviously, software developers requires none to see people face to face. In nature, developer can work remotely everywhere. So even before pandemic hits us in 2018 and 2019, remote working is already a trend for software developer. And then digital marketing, this position is the key to grow our digital startup ecosystem, because using digital marketing we can reach our product, we can reach our customer to market our product directly to their phone, to their laptop, even to their television today. There's social media admin, graphic designer, marketplace online shop admin. This is one kind of way obvious to support the e-commerce market, and sales officer and market research. And then we also have financial administration that once again, this is not required to working at office fully, because financial officer at admin, legal, human capital, basically, they can still working in front of laptop only. And then the latest one is operation, looking for the some edutech, education in technology, like One Guru or maybe Udemy, etc. Operation, like a license officer, and project and product lead, atau class operation is still required and can be done remotely. So this is the opportunity for us as a student to work everywhere we want, because even though you are located in quite remotely location, you can still be working well with your office in big cities, or even student in Indonesia can also work remotely to a company in Malaysia, right? This is one kind of opportunity that embracing us we have to grab this opportunity, because this is one of the accelerating trend that we can utilize to upgrade our skills. So I'm going to compare about what is the difference between work environment in the corporate and then unicorn startups, like we all know Lazada, not Lazada maybe, Tokopedia, Bukalapak, Grab, and something. In the corporate, we are bound with employment or internship program. So we have to put our ears very, very sensitive to when the employment or the internship program is started and when it ended, and what is the liabilities and what is the responsibilities for each program. So we cannot apply whenever we want. So we have to comply with the program. And then the second one is the specific, the in the corporate, we have specific and deep scope. What I mean is, when you come to corporate, the field, the horizontal is very huge. And then everyone has this very, very specific kind of a job spec or job description. And but with this kind of specific job description, we have a deep scope that we have to analyze thoroughly from the upper ground to the lower ground. So we are responsible for the specific things and with the very deep scope. This is the challenges for the corporate internship. And then we have to follow existing workflow. This is what differs very, very distinctive with between the corporate and also the small startup. In the corporate, you have the workflow or the standard operation procedure is already established, and you have to follow this. And the possibility you to change or to improve the procedure is a very, very low, because especially if you are the internship. The next one is bureaucratic, because you are allowed to speak only your upper line and also your peers. You cannot talk directly to CEO. You have no chain of command there, and this is what makes the corporate environment is specific. And you also have lots of peers that has the same position with you. So you are going to work collaboratively. You have to cooperate with your peers with the same position, and you have to discuss a lot. All things who as a team. The next one is unicorn startup. In this unicorn startup is different with corporate, because we still has the level of startup, a temporary company that is very, very agile and also very, very fast. Corporate is one company that is already settled. So in startup, especially in a unicorn startup, the program is 50-50 between bound or flexible. So you have to look very, very carefully when or how to enter the unicorn startup as internship. Yeah. The second one is unicorn startup has medium scope, but still deep. So you have bigger responsibilities rather than in corporate ones. In unicorn startup, you might have as a digital marketer, you have to analyze market, and then you have menguasai itu apa ya? Mastering, you have to master LinkedIn ads, Instagram ads, and a lot of tools there. But you still have to have a deep knowledge and expertise in that kind particular position. And the next one, you can. There is a possibility for us to extend existing workflow, not replacing, but extending, because the workflow or the procedure is already established, but still needs perfection, time by time. And the next one, in unicorn startup, we are semi-bureaucratic, more flexible. Why? Because in unicorn startup, the chain of command is already established and pretty deep, but we. In terms of the work culture, we allow to have the internship to talk or communicate directly with the CEO or board of directors. There is more flexibility in terms of the communication and chain of command as well. And the last one is lots of peers with the same position, but still still have a responsibility with medium and deep scope within each other. And the last one is the early stage startup, where we incubate in Legal Hub, especially. The program is very flexible. As long as you know who is the co-founder, as long as you know who is the leader, you can ask if you have internship. You can start by sending the email, and then you may have the internship program started by 1 or 2 months later. There is a very flexible program with sometimes the the end of the program is only one month, 2 months, 3 months, different between each participants. So there is a very, very flexible program. Or even if I can say there is no program, you can enter and leave anytime. The second one, you have large but also rather shallow scope, because this is a startup. You have to understand all the things. If you apply as a digital or a graphic designer, we expect you to be able to fix the printer as well. Yeah, rather shallow, but you have great, big, large, and large impact. Last even for the startup, because startup only consists at maximum only 10 people maybe. So we expect when our internship comes, and I hope you can do all the things that we cannot do by today. And then the third one, as an internship, you have you can extend existing workflow and also establish the new ones, because startup rarely have the settled workflow yet, but we can as a internship to modify or is even establishing the new workflow for the startups. So we can create a new procedure. So maybe if design, we can also as the designer, maybe we can create a design system for the startups. For the marketing, maybe we can start to establish the new way to using Buffer and also Trello, etc. And the fourth one, we can obviously we can have a direct communication with not only upper lines but also with our CEO or even investor. We have the possibility to do that. We also have sometimes we are a single fighter, because sometimes when we apply to a startup, maybe. As I mentioned before, there is maybe no program, so maybe we are the only one intern that work in the startup. So there is a trade-off between we want to work collectively with our peers internship, but in the startups, we have to expect that we will work individually. And the latest one, the work culture is not developed well, because a startup usually has no work culture, no company culture. So a co-founder or the CEO will see what is working or what is not working on the fly. So this is the pros and cons between the working at corporate, unicorn startup, the biggest one. And the latest one is the early startup, like in Indigo Hub Bandung. And then this is the advantages on working at early stage startup. The first one, you will have good understanding of a company overview and business model. This is a very, very good point if you want to establish or create a new startup as well. You will learn a lot from how to hire personnel, how to use digital marketing, and what's working and what's not working. And then you can also learn how to sell the product to the customer directly at the same time. So this is the advantages for us as an internship to learn a lot on how to do the business in early stage startup. And the second one is a lot of challenges and gain more experience in line with the startup development. So I collect this kind of benefits from our graduates. So I think this is quite valid in my side. So this is a lot of challenge. Then the internship will learn on the fly along with the startup development. The third one is less dependent on academic status, so you can apply as you don't have to graduate first, or you are applying to fulfill your college credits, etc. Or even you are not graduate yet, not attending college, you can still doing the internship. The next one is you can have a stronger bond with your colleagues and a higher opportunity. I will show you in the last slide. And then this is perfect for the first timer because as a first timer, you will have no portfolio, because in the work industry today, a portfolio or the experience is very, very critical, and it's a very, very required for us to determine is this person is suitable or for our company or not, because the experience ones can be less to train first, so they can start right away when they are appointed and hired. They can right away working well with the experience that he or she has already had. So the first timer, he's working at early stage startup, will give you a lot of learning points and lesson learned here, and this can be a good point for your portfolio for the expertise that will empower your CVs for the professional job hunting. Especially in Eagle Hub Bandung, we count on internship as well. We are a team of five. And a lot of the technical things, we delegate it to our internships. So we already have 40 plus internship alumni that we all hired during 2018 until today. And today itself, we also running and hired four internships that is spread in a content creator and also a graphic designer. The benefits for this internship is they will get the certificate, and then they are able to work have networking with the startup founders and mentors that is incubated in Indigo Hub Bandung. And they also have full access to Indigo Hub Bandung facility like refreshment, meeting room, multimedia devices, high-end PC, and Friday free lunch for some if there is a particular event. And this is Meet Martin, especially this Martin is our alumni, and today we hired Martin as our video graphic designer or creative designer at MDI. So basically, Indigo Hub Bandung is running under MDI. MDI is one of the biggest venture capital in Indonesia, one was active. And last year, we are appointed as the best venture capital in Indonesia. And Martin is hired at MDI and appointed to work as a creative designer in Indigo Hub Bandung. Thank you. Okay, that's all for me. Maybe any question?
Thank you so much, Kak Andika.
Yeah,
that was very insightful. Sorry, but can you mute? Yeah, because I got this feedback. Hello, can everyone hear me? Yep. Okay, so that was very insightful. Myself, I got a whole new perspective in viewing how the startup ecosystem is like. And I really love how in startups, as an intern, probably you can sort of like try any roles that you want in the startup. And it doesn't have to be the same with the education that you are now pursuing if you, say, have a degree in graphic design, but you want to try UI, UX coding or designing, you can definitely try that, because I see from Andika presentation that in startups, all the workers are actually very welcoming, and also they are open to new skills and then to teach you their expertise as well. Okay, so we're going to have our Q&A session. We have a few of questions coming in. And Astrid, if you want to add something before we get into the Q&A session, you can do that.
Yeah. So, okay. Hello, everyone. Yeah. Thank you so much for your attendance and participation to the session. So I see some of the participants coming from our interns. So I want to give a bit shout out for them. So thank you so much. And yeah, for other students as well. So we really appreciate also your participation, as also this can be a way you can also try out your skills to try gaining more exposure earlier from industry perspective. Because if I also can share a bit about these internship activities, because me currently also managing our interns, they mostly transforming into our full-timers right now, because most of our staffs like full-timers at course also coming from the part-time gig, professional gig working project, and then other 3 months internship activities. So yeah, it's also one of the good practice for all of you, even if your semester and the requirement from the school is not starting yet. So yeah, it's really flexible, and right now we can also start everything digitally, so the opportunities are wider. And yeah, I see also the interesting questions are coming, so maybe we can also discuss about that while answering the questions.
Okay, sure. I think all questions are for Kak Adhika, actually. So let's move in to the first questions. From Andika's experience, what do you think are the key skills that students or interns can learn from startups? Or if they want to apply for internship at startup, what skills do they have to need? Because you mentioned their academic status doesn't matter. So what are the skills that are important?
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you for the question. It depends on the position that you apply. If you are because internship has a very low characteristic of classification. Sometimes a company, startups, only require you can, let's say you are applying for a software developer. So the startup actually will put some certification or some high-end technology that you have to understand well about MVP on the microservices, blah 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 blah. But if you're an internship, as long as you understand how to install VS Code, or you install a library from the internet, and you understand well about what is PHP maybe or Node.js, this is quite good. As long as you are not very raw, as long as you all already understand, you have a laptop, and then you have you are applying for the software developer, and I want to train you how to install the application or the software. At least that is the basic skills that you need to provide or prepare before you apply. And in terms of if you are applying as a digital creative or a graphic designer, at least you already mastering or not mastering, you already familiar with Adobe Illustrator tools, Figma for today trends, or you a bit understand about composition, harmony, layouting, for the basic, very basic. So that is what kind of specific skills that you have to prepare depend on the position of the industry that you need to apply. If you're applying for the operation, at least you understand how to use WhatsApp group, at least how to use the Trello, how to use Airtable. All these kinds of tools is free. So as we, the intern, we can directly start to use maybe in our daily basis or small project. And there's no reason that you cannot use these tools.
I see. Yep, that's a good one. I think at the startups, when you're just an intern or maybe a new employee, you can just sort of learning by doing, right?
Yeah.
So don't be afraid to, if you think that your skills are not enough, you can show that you're interested in that one topic. So for example, maybe if you're interested in copywriting, please state that you're interested in UX writing and you want to know a bit more about that, just to make it relevant to your skills and what are you interested in. Okay, so next up, this is a bit more technical. So Kanika, what kind of programming language is good at before achieving all of this? So Restu wants to know what kind of programming language he should master for joining startups. Maybe, yeah, that's the question.
I think there is a Xcode, something said like Xcode, or maybe can you help me to put in the chat, private chat maybe? So as a software developer, you can still mastering depending on the position. If you're applying as a web developer, at least you understand how to use Familiar.js. At least you understand how to create a basic HTML structure using a proper tag, maybe with a media or maybe iframe, etc. For mobile app, especially for iOS, you are required to have MacBook first, because developing app in iOS is having a MacBook Pro or MacBook is a required one. It's a mandatory.
Oh, I see. So again, before you yeah, that's a really great answer. I think before you apply to internship roles or job, make sure that you do a little bit of research. If you're applying for web designing, please search beforehand what kind of programming language that.
In addition, maybe I can
web design.
Yeah, maybe I can add a bit about non-technical perspective. At least as an internship, you have to research a bit about what is the company, because a lot of the internship going to GitHub Bandung or startup cannot describe what is the GitHub Bandung, and is there. I recognize they only heard about or only read from our website. So basically, the candidates that only read our description website is rejected. So we are expecting the candidates to learn at least a week before about what is course, what is Indigo Hub Bandung, what is the specialty, and it's, usually I personally always ask about what is your feedback about our company or startup. That feedback sometimes will be added as our task to do in the internship program.
I see. So that's a bit of secret of how to get employers to choose you. So make sure that you show your enthusiasm towards the company. Please learn a bit more about what the company does and what the roles will require you to master. And then, a lot of questions.
Natalie, can I just add? Natalie, can I just add?
Definitely.
Yeah, I think what is important is that the mindset of the person who is applying for the job, you sort of take the initiative to try not only find out about the company, but also maybe to learn some skills before that, like upskill your own self or reskill what you have learned. So there are a lot of opportunities where you can do this sort of semi-training or online training. It will be to your benefit. And I think as an employer, it speaks a lot for the intern if they've taken that initiative on your own. Am I not right, Andika? You can see the difference of an intern who has taken the initiative and one who hasn't.
Yeah, it's not only for internship application, but also for professional job application as well.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Of course. You can tell the difference in your team. Yes.
Sure. Yeah. If you can find this trait or have behavior first, we can do everything for all kinds of industries. You don't have to worry about skills.
Right. And I think that's why it's so important to have this early stage exposure, so they actually understand what businesses want, what employers are looking for, and how to actually get ahead, because there are a lot of competition, a lot of peers, so you need to sort of stand out. So having the early stage exposure, you actually are a bit more confident in yourself. You know what you can do. You know how you can improve. So I think this is a really good opportunity for them to grow as well as to prove themselves for future employment. Yeah?
Talking about competition, I forgot to mention in my slide that we already have 40 plus alumni, but we don't mention about how much we reject.
Rejection. Yep.
I think we already have 1,000 more application that we reject, because we still have to shortlist. We cannot hire everyone. So we have to choose the best one from the applicant. So in the end, our internship is the one that already at least one portfolio, working portfolio. Even though the portfolio is minor, not a big project, at least they already have a grasp with the industry that they apply.
Yeah, and I think when it's working in a startup or in a smaller company, there's more synergy, because you get to explore, you get to share your ideas, brainstorm together, and then because you do it, you actually have a sense of ownership. You feel that you belong to the team, so you want to do more. I mean, I think that's very interesting, because when you're involved in it and your passion comes across, that's when you know, yes, I'm in the right track, and people can see it. It's very evident in the team. You know, you have leaders and you have followers, sort of thing. And it actually creates a very good opportunity for the young people to sort of develop themselves and carry themselves further. This is a whole new way, the whole new shape of working, future of jobs, isn't it? Yeah. It's very different. And actually, it's applicable to those in the technical or digital companies, as well as non-digital companies or positions. Yeah, but it's very interesting. And it's the same for Indonesia and Malaysia as well, or all over the world, maybe.
Yeah, they need to change their
mindset. Yes, that's right.
Okay, so next up, we have another one. I'm just going to pick random questions from the list. So e-commerce and online media are growing rapidly during the pandemic. So for those of us who are still in college, but also want to try to build a startup, but very busy on campus, what can you suggest, Kanika, for the students who are eager to build their own startups? Is there a program to support that?
Okay. There are a lot of programs. Especially in Indonesia, I don't know about in Malaysia industry, but in Indonesia there are a lot of programs. Even if you are in the university in Indonesia, like ITB or UNPAD, they already have a program to incubate the student. So you are not required to graduate first, and then they are still open for building early stage entrepreneurship. But still, they will require you to graduate fast. So please make sure that you have to balance between your passion and also your responsibility as a student.
Yeah, right. Like most of the students have a lot of activities, but not being able to like maintain their real original schedule, which is the school's classes. And any other thing will actually support their portfolio. And yeah, it's quite a lot of benefit for them, actually, for free, with no amount of fee at all.
You have to choose between your professional, your business, or your skill upgrading, or even your academic life, once again, or you have to sacrifice your sleep.
Yeah.
Another one, this is very interesting. I'm just going to ask this in Bahasa Indonesia because the question is in Bahasa Indonesia. Bagaimana startup bisa selamat atau survive terutama di masa pandemi COVID-19? Jadi mungkin dari teman-teman ada yang ragu untuk apply ke startup karena mungkin work culture-nya kurang tidak se-established seperti big company, Kak. Jadi untuk encourage the students to apply.
Okay,
we can do that.
I'm trying to aku bakal coba jawab ini in dari student perspective ya. You can read a lot of journal or reports developed by a lot of VCs or consultant, like the ones that I used in Google, Temasek, and Bain Company. This is used with jadi report yang Bain Company ini dipakai juga oleh Angin. One of angel investor venture capital, dan perlu banyak belajar dari situ sih untuk melihat grafik, terus kemudian korelasi satu dan lainnya. Saya pun masih belajar di situ, tapi dari situ kita bisa melihat bahwa kadang-kadang report yang bagus juga memberikan insight not only about the data. They will provide some insights. The ones that I read from the paint company that I shown before. Contohnya ya kayak, even though in the end the 2025 the graphic is scaling very rapidly, but still there is an insight that e-commerce food travel, food and travel, and also the travel, food and what the first the ones. Share ya.
Yeah, oh yeah, saya share.
Stop sharing.
Kategorinya.
I'm afraid that my WhatsApp is being visible to all over.
That's okay, that happens. Don't worry about it. Yeah.
Okay. Tadi yang masih report ya. Jadi belajar dari report aja sih. Sekarang insight-nya ya. Banyak bermain di startup yang dia produce produk yang tidak perlu ada proximity requirement, kayak misalnya online travel, we are on travel ban maybe, we are on travel restriction, all people have to stay at home 24/7, itu bakal memberikan efek kepada bisnis si travel itu. Jadi kita mungkin lebih fokus pada yang kayak misalnya SaaS atau software as a service, untuk produk-produk yang punya memberikan kayak they provide the collaboration tools like Trello, Notion, etc. Even though di Indonesia they are very limited startup that plays on SaaS industry. Terus kemudian juga main di mungkin bisa belajar mencari startup-startup yang basisnya edutech. So basically in the Indigo we have for focus this year. Two of them is in edutech and also then telemedicine and also IoT that requires none of proximity requirement. Because sebelum pandemi, way before pandemic hits us, travel and tourism is one of the pioneer of one of private prima donna as our yang paling bagus lah ya, yang paling bagus yang kira wah ini kayak bagus banget nih, potensi tinggi banget karena Indonesia bakal punya travel segala macam gitu. Tapi in the end ternyata pandemic muncul, COVID-19, travel hits hard, banyak yang collapse, bahkan pada saat itu juga ada beberapa startup Indigo yang memang butuh adanya travel itu. Dia main travel and tourism dan they died. Startup instantly died. So that's the reality, that's the fact. So buat teman-teman yang mau main di industri, coba banyak dulu belajar dari report-report yang ada. Banyak prediksi-prediksi yang mungkin di belakang juga prediksi. This is a prediction, not a certainty ya. There's no certainty. But still, you can see what the expert sees in 2025. The expert, not the foreteller.
Saya kira itu menjawab pertanyaan dari Bagas Keras juga. He asked about the potentials of digital startups and digital ecosystem. So in the startup ecosystem, it's important to look at data because nothing is fixed, ya kak. Everything is based on changes. That's why the culture is very agile. Okay, let's move on to another question. I think this is a bit more operational. So Reni, he wants to know how in the time of pandemic, startups save up their operational costs due to declining income. Saya juga penasaran kak, mungkin kalau bisa nambah, startup itu kan memang sudah sebelum pandemi semuanya digital dan timnya juga lean kan biasanya. Nah, sebanyak apa sih perubahan yang dihadapi startup dibanding company-company lain?
Okay, compared to the big companies, big corporates, the differences is very small in terms of the value, because in terms of the nominal rupiah or US dollar, but in percentage still hits hard. Makanya kalau misalnya mungkin aku agak blend ya antara Indonesian English. Jadi kalau misalnya the startups, how startups streamlines their incomes or expense, they simply fire people. Ya kadang-kadang startup itu ada yang dia fire people, ngepecat. Even though one of the biggest startups in Indonesia maybe, they fired their senior developers and they keep the junior developers just to make the runway still long, so they don't have to die, but they have to sacrifice lots of their senior developers, senior level employees. So is this a good news? Depend on who we are. If we are the founder, this is the bad news. We have to rebuild our what we've been built for long years, and then yeah, we have to rehire again with different salary. But for the intern, this is one of the best moment because you will have more impact for the startups. Even though you are not paid so big, let's say, ya gitu sih. Jadi kalau misalnya dari startup, ya kayaknya sih streamlining seperti itu ya. Somehow tetap harus jualan kan, tetap harus ngeluarin duit untuk marketing, etc. operational. Tapi yang bisa di shrinking down adalah salary expense. Some startups also mainin apa ya, dirumahkan ya, so layoffing practically sama juga sama memecat, tapi dia lebih sopan sih. Jadi memang banyaknya saya jarang lihat startup yang mungkin strateginya untuk ngecilin dana itu dengan cara selain layoffing sih, karena for the startup industry especially in digital, human resources takes up to 50% or 70% of all expenses.
I see. But I try to see this in the student perspective again. This is such a boon to us because apparently the startups are cutting off the senior staff instead of the junior. So it's the junior ones that are welcome to the companies. This is very new to me, Kak, because I just knew about this fact. I thought the junior are the ones who are being retrenched. Tapi ternyata malah seniornya, karena itu junior staff ternyata atau talent saving cost dan mungkin apa ya, masih bisa di ini ya Kak, trayek karirnya itu masih bisa ditempuh lagi gitu ya. Jadi seperti investment untuk startup mungkin. Itu yeah. I think we're almost hitting 1 hour. I think this is the time for one last question. Let me just scroll down. Okay, the last one. This is a shortest question of all. Why must join startups?
Wow.
Yeah.
Why? Why? Especially me, ya. Saya, kenapa saya join startup ya? Okay.
And I think in their perspective, because I know the one who asked is a student, maybe he is debating whether to join a big company or startup. So why startup?
Okay, so why startup? By doing startup, you can have a lot of lesson learned in very limited time. You can learn about marketing, how to hire people management, or selling, or operation, how to do legal, how to tax, etc. in very short term. Within 1 year, you already know everything on your side, on your own. That is the hard truth of the startups. But in return, we are more likely to provide a real impact to the society. So doing startups is not entirely you can get rich in a very, very, let's say, you can get instantly rich, but you will get instantly more useful to the society. But I don't recommend for you as fresh graduates to directly to startups, because I believe that the best startup founder is the best employees in the world. So you have to learn from the other people first before you are leading your own team with no professional background. They will hit you hard, very hard, and you will lose many things.
So Andika, isn't it right to say that when you join a startup, basically you learn end to end of the business, you learn everything, every level. Yep. So you get more confidence. So if you start early, when you go in, you will know how it's done, and you can probably take over the startup or the CEO position soon. If you have learned everything.
Everything. As the startup owner, you may have a meeting with government at 10 a.m. at 10 morning, and in 12 noon you can mop the floor. It's still possible.
Is that flexible?
By doing the staff founder,
time management.
Jadi kesempatan untuk dilibatkan itu lebih besar ya, karena kan kalau kita bandingkan dengan perusahaan yang udah established, itu dari angka anggota staffnya udah banyak sekali gitu. Dibandingkan dengan startup yang perbandingannya mungkin 1:10 untuk total dari keseluruhan tim yang terlibat gitu. Jadi kesempatan untuk explore lebih dalamnya lebih besar juga.
Kalau pengen cepat belajar emang enak di startup, tapi kalau pengen cepat di hire, benernya ya di corporate sih. Karena udah terbiasa dengan birokrasi, etc.
Yeah, I see. Yep. So if you want to learn more, go for startup, right, Kak?
Yeah.
Because people are bumping into each other ideas. You know, the culture is just like that. There is no restrictive structure, I think. So you can learn marketing, you can learn sales, you can even learn tech in your lunch break, maybe. Yeah. So with that With that last question, I think we're going to wrap up this stream. It's been a fun 1 hour, and I think we are all now so inspired and like enlightened after we hear Kandika presentation and his stories about life at Indigo Hub. So I think as a youth talent, it's don't be afraid to open as many doors in your career, because you can always learn, you can always try new things. And if you want to plunge into startups, don't hesitate, because it's just going to take you into a constant learning curve. You can learn new things, meet new people. So yeah. So thanks everyone for tuning in, and have a lovely Friday. Bye.
Thank you, Andika. Thank you, Natalie.
Thank you, Andika. Thank you, Astrid.
Just to mention, if anyone has any questions or need to know more, maybe you could just drop us an email at hqsl@quirk.my. Natalie, maybe you can put it up so that they can know if there's any questions, further questions, or how we can explore. Yeah, so this is for Malaysian students, Indonesian students, for everyone. Yeah, we'll love to hear from you.
Yeah.
All right, take care now. Enjoy the weekend.
Take care, everyone.
Bye.